We begin with this morning's top story, American forces back in action in Iraq.
Today I authorized two operations in Iraq. I know that many of you are rightly concerned about any American military action in Iraq, even limited strikes like these. I understand that. I ran for this office in part to end our war in Iraq and welcome our troops home. But when the lives of American citizens are at risk, we will take action. Earlier this week, one Iraqi in the area cried to the world, "There is no one coming to help." Well, today America is coming to help.
Charlie, don't surf!
Got into a huge argument about your shirt. And it was like a big old scene, and I was like, why is this fucking scene? Like, it was just crazy. And like, I was explaining about the Sync Summit to another group of people, and I was like, yeah, this friend, he had a shirt, and I was trying to explain the significance of Radio8Ball and what had happened with you wearing that shirt and then the woman who came before you and everything. And I was saying, yeah, it said Charlie Don't Surf, and it had a picture of Charlie Manson, and it was a reference to the Beach Boys, because he wrote music for the Beach Boys, but he didn't surf, but neither did today, so whatever. And then it's a reference to Apocalypse Now with Robert Duvall, which comes with this extra irony or whatever. Anyways, and she had this really strong reaction. She said that that's promoting serial killers. And I was like, oh, shit. And I was like, well, you know, it's a satire that's ironic on many different levels and all this stuff. And she was like, no, that's supporting. She got really reactive, and she's like, that's supporting serial killers. It was just so funny, because it was over this shirt, and I was like, you don't even, like, Charlie Don't Surf. Like, yeah. Oh my God, dude. Oh my God, on so many levels at the same time. You know, because it's war, and they're killing all these people, and it's like, and Apocalypse Now, like, glorified it in a sense. And it's just like, they're killing, they just wiped out all these fucking people. And then he's like, do you read, like, this is what,
yeah.
The death of one is a tragedy, and the death of millions is a statistic.
Exactly.
And because they're, like, you know, on the other side of the world or whatever, it's like, what, you know.
Yeah. Well, it didn't happen here.
So. Everything. It's just, yeah. And so, it's interesting what it ends up doing when you start contemplating in that way, because you can see the mass play and the way that values operate, and the way that it's all just so fucking illusory, because there's the realities of what is happening and the depths of what is happening, and then there's something on top of it that's just not the true reality of what's actually taking place. And that's, you know, it's really an intense thing to try to convey, is like the multi-tiers of it, because you want to make one point and not negate the other.
Yeah.
But it's as if there's this polarization of mind, that there's this
intense
resistance to that. And is that character armor? Like, is that, what is that? Like, where does that come from? Like, fuck.
Feeling a little lost? Well, in our previous episode, Brielle, a pregnant woman, asked,
"Is it a boy or a girl?"
And got the creepy as fuck answer. The songs are all dead at birth because there's nobody behind the scene. It'll become obvious how Brielle's question ties into the one you are about to hear in just a few minutes. But first, you'll need one more bit of context. At every Radio8Ball show, there are 8 numbers on the wheel and 8 songs on the board. If the wheel lands on a number that has already been chosen, the guest is invited to pick a card from the remaining song list. That's what you'll be observing in this next question. Let's get to it.
You ready? We're good? And the next guest on Radio8Ball is the fucking Violator.
Before I went on, I was thinking, I hope I don't go on, but I knew I would. And after I came off, I had a lot more Thanks, Shmushy.
Thank you. Thank you, Violator. Can I call you just Violator?
Yes.
Okay, Violator. Wow, you really just put your... Yeah, you are the guy. You definitely are putting your dick out there. I appreciate that. So, Violator, would you please read your question for the Pop Oracle and keep your Charlie in your pants?
What do I have to accomplish before I die?
What do you have to accomplish before you die? Okay. And now, to engage the Pop Oracle, you get to pick a card.
Any card. Any card. Pick a card. Any card. Pick a card. Any card.
Song number 7. She's not going home with you. That's not the question. He didn't ask, is she going home with me? Don't get worried. He asked a different question. He asked, what do I have to accomplish before I die?
Oh, this is brutal.
Can we cut this whole scene out of the show?
No, this is going in. This is totally going in.
She's not going home with you, and I apologize in advance for this.
So you came on a Greyhound bus from a tiny town in Arizona just to see her play. For a couple of whiskey cokes and watching her when she is only 20 feet away from you. And now, what can you do? You can hang around the club and drink away your fear. You can tell her all about the hate that brought you here, but you'll never be in her career. She's not going home with you. With every step you take, you're even farther than you were. She's not going home with you. Just remember to pay your tab and stay away from her. If you put a single coil at the bridge of your Les Paul, I bet you'd have some more control. Just because she didn't get you kicked out right away, you think you've got some kind of goal at her, but it never made it so. You say you've got a radio show and you could give her band a plug, but you'll only make that offer if she gives you a hug. Cause there's fear in your heart and it's a drug. She's not going home with you. It doesn't matter how long she's been on your stereo. She's not going home with you. Your sofa may be comfortable, but she will never know. Na 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 na. Not going home with you. Na 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 na.
I hate you.
So that was She's Not Going Home With You by a great monoreal song performed there by Peter David Connolly. The answer to the fucking Violator's question, what do I have to accomplish in my life? There was another question in here. Why is
Why is Violator so evil?
Why is Violator so evil?
I didn't write that one.
But... what do I have to accomplish before I die? And you chose, what do I have to accomplish before I die? And you got the answer, she's not going home with you. Before we get into it, and I know Peter thought it seemed really harsh, but who were you writing that to? What was the circumstance?
That is a true one. I used to be in this band that was all women other than me.
What was the band?
The drummer that was called Bangs. And a lot of times in certain parts of the country, Texas and Florida come to mind in particular, there would be, need a groupie sort of dudes hanging around after the show, and a lot of times, or more cunning than that, in this particular case, a guy was like, to one of the women in the band, was like, I want to talk to you about your guitar. And what year is that? What kind of pickups you got in that? What kind of, how do you clean it off? Or whatever. After, 150 shows of that happening, you get pretty fed up with it, even if you're not one of the women in the band. And there are specific lines in that song that are things a particular person actually said in Seattle, I think was the show. And just a lot of, people, hey, you can stay over at my house, you can stay on our couch, and you get a sort of sleaze ball feeling about that proposition. And, we were all pretty good at having, decent feelers about that and being able to tell who maybe we should stay over at their place and who we shouldn't. So that's what that song's about.
So Violator, you ever feel like you're one of, who do you feel like in that story? Do you feel like one, like the band on tour, the guy who's in the band on tour who's noticing?
Yeah, wait,
this?
what was the exact phrasing of the question again?
What do I need to accomplish before I die? Can I jump in? Like for me, it might be like noticing how I, noticing how my sort of genuine expression of enthusiasm for things might creep other people out. I mean, I did start the show by talking about my dick. It could, that could very easily have come off as being, sexually aggressive in some way that might make someone uncomfortable.
Well, your name's Shmushkin, after all.
Well, I think that's a very sweet name.
I was uncomfortable being in the front row when you're talking about whipping it out and shmushing it on us.
Yeah. Well, I'm glad. I like to make you. I like to make people feel something. So, but Violator. I mean, your name is Violator. It does. You set yourself. You sort of pose as. You're wearing the Charlie Manson shirt. If you came up to me at a show and were like, you want to
sleep
at
on my couch?
House? my alarms might go off. I'm just saying.
It's maybe it plays on both, maybe on both people in it. And sometimes I'm the Violator and sometimes I'm just Jeremy. I don't know if I can mention this, but I picked four on the wheel, which is death in Japanese. So if you're in Japan, they put all the foreigners on the fourth floor. Like here, it's 13, which 1 + 3 = 4. And then I pulled 7, which is the lucky number. So I had the unlucky number and then lucky number, so I have both going there. So maybe I sometimes the annoying creep, and then sometimes the person on stage as
you are right now. And sometimes you're the annoying creep on stage. Something I know a little bit about.
It might not be as negative as that, though. I mean, maybe it's like...
You're the one who started off by saying, oh, I'm so sorry, this is awful.
Yeah, but after saying that, I'm trying to find a positive light in here, and maybe it just means that your destiny is to be a pro-feminist musician performer or something.
I have no musical talent. Maybe it's... I would take it to a more spiritual realm where I have to merge like opposites in me or become more whole before I die.
Yeah.
That sort of.
That's good. We all have to do that. Thank you.
Thank you.
You got some applause. Violator. Very good. Will you pick the next guest on Radio 8-Ball? And now, Violator. Sorry, I called you by your real name. I know your real name, so I have to. So, you get a prize from Last Word Books, one of our sync books. They're providing the sync books, and they're selling their books back there. By the way, give it up for Last Word Books. It's coming out here and doing this. Have you been to the new location? Have you guys been to the new location? It's great. Over on Cherry Street, right across from Olympia
Sync Book
Coffee
Volume Roasters. 1, Chapter 3 is me.
Oh, yeah, Jeremy is his Sync Book Volume 1, and you are going to have this book from Baruch called Spilled Blood and False is False God and Real Estate.
I think that answers my question.
There you go. Give it up for Violator, the fucking Violator.
All right, let's start off with the unavoidable and obviously uncomfortable correlation that many of us syncheads in the audience picked up on. Jeremy / Violator takes the stage wearing a t-shirt that, whatever the satirical and ironic intention behind the design, you know, it has Charles Manson's fucking face on it. Any and all subtlety of the t-shirt is then overshadowed by the context of the question just before this being asked by a pregnant woman. Manson, of course, is most infamous for his role in the brutal murder of Sharon Tate, who was 8.5 months pregnant at the time. If it weren't for the fact that Brielle's baby is happy and healthy, and Brielle herself has been very supportive of this whole sync exploration, I would be terrified to point out the physical similarities between the two women. I'm still horrified, mind you, but I feel responsible to report this to you as honestly as possible. Both of these Radio8Ball questions also end up talking about creeps and predators hanging around the edges of the music industry. Manson was a frustrated musician who never achieved real success, and so lashed out at the quasi-elite celebrity and money world of Los Angeles.
Guess I'll hit Los Angeles, bottom billed when no one asked me to play. It's either that or commit to stay. Well, my new songs are all dead at birth because there's nobody behind the scene. What I need is a twitchy thug, evens out the deal with the club to the knees.
Terry Melcher was a producer, a music producer that Charles Manson wanted to associate with. He wanted him to produce his records. And I believe he had a meeting with Melcher, and eventually Melcher just decided to drop Manson's idea. He wasn't that impressed, and the legend goes that Manson went to the CLO Drive house, you know, Polanski and Tate's house, to retaliate, and his target was allegedly Terry Melcher, and he did not know that Melcher had moved and that Polanski and Tate had taken over the lease.
You can tell her all about the hate that brought you here, but you'll never be in her career.
All of this becomes even more fucked up when we remember that the Radio8Ball show was taking place on August 8th, which is basically the fucking anniversary of the murders. Let's return to Patrick Sivek and David Plate for a little more context.
So this story all starts on August 8th, 1969 at 11:30 a.m. in London. The Beatles took their iconic photograph of their Abbey Road album, Crossing the Street. And around that same time in Laurel Canyon, America, Charlie Manson told his family that now is the time for Helter Skelter. So later that night, after midnight, which is technically August 9th, but it was still the same, you know, day as the 8th, the Manson family went to the Sharon Tate Roman Polanski residence and committed their infamous murder there.
They cross the street on a zebra crossing. Sharon Tate gets killed on a zebra rug.
hold on to that zebra detail that David just mentioned, as it will remain important. Just before the Radio 8 Ball show started, Ezra Sanzerbell gave a talk that not only dealt with the Abbey Road cover, but also the significance of the zebra.
The zebra is actually conspiring to create all of these synchronicities. So, in a way, for Philip K. Dick, zebra is the god of synchronicity, if you will.
That's one way of looking at the zebra, though with Brielle's question,
is it a boy or a girl?
Followed by,
and sometimes I'm the violator and sometimes I'm just Jeremy.
We can easily see the zebra as a representation of duality or the attempt to see beyond it.
You're talking about opposites uniting in front of a huge yin-yang symbol stuff,
where I have to merge like opposites in me or become more whole before I die.
I opened up this episode with the reminder that Obama, after quote-unquote ending the war in Iraq, began bombing it again the day before our Sync Summit. The timing of this attack on Babylon seems just as ritualistic as the Tate-LaBianca murders, and those murders were every bit as political as any military coup. As David said at the start, the death of one is a tragedy, and the death of millions is a statistic. But if we are still interested in an answer to what is real, then we'd try to bring equal amounts of compassion and outrage to both events, which on an archetypal level are the same event. Maybe the reason Charlie couldn't surf was because he could only see the particle and not the wave. We need to understand that everything is connected and attempt to look past the polarization to see both at the same time.
Because there's the realities of what is happening and the depths of what is happening. And then there's this, there's something on top of it that's just not the true reality of what's actually taking place. And that's, you know, that's really an intense thing to try to convey, is like the multi-tiers of it. Because you want to make one point and not negate the other.
Yeah.
But it's as if there's this polarization of mind that there's this intense resistance to that.
The one thing I'd ask you not to resist is the temptation to stay tuned. Because if you do, you'll get episode 6 and the next question.
Oh,